What's up, everyone? St. R. Edwards here. Welcome back to the Ski Channel, Swift Coding for Everyone. We're going to continue on in lesson 2.10. In this particular lesson, we're going to go over size classes, varying for traits, and we're also going to talk about the installed button. All right, so go ahead and open up your Xcode project where we're talking about auto layout practice, what you see on the screen, and we're going to continue on. All right. So as you're designing apps and or even just thinking about the concept of how you want your app to look, you know, it may be a little overwhelming to think about the different, you know, screen sizes and, you know, different devices that you have to design for. Well, Apple has made that, you know, very, very convenient for us as developers. And they made that convenient by creating size classes. Now, if you look down here at the bottom of the Xcode project, you'll see right now I'm currently viewing this app as an iPhone 4S. And as you can see, it's got WCHR. And that currently stands for compact width and regular height. So that itself is a size class and it belongs to a trait. All right. And so I'm gonna go back to the iPhone 8. And as you can see, compact width and regular height for this device. So that's a size class. All right. Now, as far as varying for traits, so depending on what type of collection it belongs to, you may have the ability to modify constraints or even some properties, you know, depending on what you're trying to change. So I'll give you guys an example. So right now, you know, we're looking at the stack view, you know, with our name and a couple of different things, you know, about us or, you know, whatever was on our minds from the other day, right? So with the stack view highlighted, this is what we're going to do. So say for instance, so for right now, we're viewing this as a compact width and regular height device. Now, there are a bunch of other devices that fit this size class. So instead of you trying to think about, oh man, I gotta develop and design for like 20 different iOS devices. Well, it's really only a few. So if you just think about it as doing it towards a size class, it's easier and it's, you know, it's a little bit, you know, comprehensible. All right. So what we're going to do is this. Since we want to say, for instance, we wanted, you know, the spacing to be different for like the iPad. So the iPad is when you view it at the, you know, the portrait orientation, and you also view it to the full screen adaptation, because you can view an iPad in several different ways because of the whole split screen thing, right? And even when you put it in landscape, you know, there are more adaptations, okay? So this is where size classes come in. So we're gonna do this. So for the regular width and regular height, we wanna set a variation to for the spacing. So right now, my stack view is currently, you know, it's in a vertical axis, it's center alignment equals centering. Well, let's say when it's a regular width and regular height device, we want the spacing to be like 40. You know, 40 pixels from, you know, each other, you know, each leg will be 40, you know, away. So we're going to do this. So at the bottom of the screen, in the right hand corner by the alignment, you know, the alignment button and the constraints button, there's a button that says vary for traits. Click that button. And let's say we wanted to vary it. Let's just say by width and height. That says 26. So right now with only the height selected, you can see it says varying 26 regular height devices. And then you can hit the down button or up button, and you can see all the devices that applies to this specific trait. But we want to do it for both. We want to do regular width and regular height. So what we're going to do is, all right, let me do this. I'm going to hit done varying, and I'm going to say vary for traits, and I'm going to select both of them. So now this applies to 10 devices that has a regular width and regular height, as you can see. And all of these down here in blue, and you know, including their adaptations and orientations, they all apply to this. So this is what we're gonna do. So with that highlighted, we're gonna go up and make sure your attributes inspector is highlighted, is selected. And we're gonna, so underneath the spacing, or right next to it, we're going to hit the plus sign that says add constraints or add variation. So we're going to click that, and we want it to be regular width and regular height. All right. Okay. So we're going to go add variation. And now we're going to change that from 10 to 40. All right. And so boom. And now we can hit the blue button that says done varying. All right. So to see if this works, all you got to do is just test it out. So we're looking at it right now on the iPad, 9.7 inch iPad. So I'm going to go to down to like an iPhone 8. I'm going to go back to the 8. All right. So now is, you know, now the spacing is back at, you know, the 10 pixels or whatever. Okay. So as you can see, and this one as well, you know, it's the same, but when you click on the iPad and then even changing the orientations, depending on, you know, if it fits that, you know, size class, yep, regular width, regular height. So yeah, so that's a way of designing across multiple devices by using the varying for traits property for, you know, different size classes. All right. So the next thing is this. So say for instance, you wanted a certain, you know, in our case, like a certain label not to appear for a certain orientation. Well, you can do what you call the install button. So this install button right here shows us that, of course, this stack view is installed. But let's say if we were looking at it in a compact device, we could change that. So we can take away our name label, for instance, if you wanted to, or we can take away the bottom label or any other label that you choose. So, you know, just for ease, I'll just select my name. You can do whichever one you like. So you can do this. So kind of in the same manner, this is what we'll do. So as you can see down here where it says install, if you hit this button, this the one that says add customization, we're going to keep the width at regular. Or actually, let's do width at any. So for any width is fine. But for height, we want this to affect the compact devices. All right, so we're going to go add variation. And as you can see, that is, you know, currently is checked, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to simply just uncheck this button. So for any width device, you know, whether it's regular or compact, it's going to show up. But specifically for the compact height, this won't show up because we're going to uncheck this button now. All right, so let's test this out. So currently we're on a regular width and regular height device. Let's go down to something compact. And as you can see, I went down to the iPhone 8 Plus, and now that first label doesn't show up. All right, so it worked. So regular width, regular height, and same for this device. And of course, and it's because it's in the, you know, the landscape orientation. So all of these are compact down here like that. But when I go back up to portrait, you know, it changes as, you know, the size class changes and the orientation changes. All right. So that's another example. So you guys need to play around with that and, you know, experiment a little bit on your own. This is St. R. Edwards with the Ski Channel, Swift Coding for Everyone. You guys take care.